What is up with the world? You are watching the Ice Drink Gaming Channel. I hope everyone's having a wonderful day today. Today we're going to continue playing some more Ark Survival Evolved on the center map. I made some changes to my base areas and stuff, so I just want to basically walk you through it. Today's video, I think what we're going to do is we're going to go out and try to find another... Dung Beetle to tame. I just got done taming a new one today, so that's what we think we're gonna do today. But yeah, we're just gonna take you. I'm gonna take you over there to show you exactly where to go to grab it. I just grabbed this quest from a guy that's been inactive for a long time, and I've been pumping his weight. It's at 16,000 weight right now. So I've been pumping his weight because he's going to be more towards getting when I go grab metal bars and stuff. So, I mean, that's what I'm going to be doing for that. But yeah, let me take you on a detour, show you exactly the. Wait, that only has two gas. Let's go grab some more gasoline here. Let's check our generator, see if we have enough gas for that. Because that's going to suck if we run out of generator. Okay, where's our gas? Nope, wrong one. Let's get in this one. Here we go. All right, so now what we're going to do is we're going to split this in like so. All right, so let's go pop that in there. Like so. That way we got some more gasoline for that. Turn that on. All right, let's rod the elevator. Yeah, I just got done taming some T-Rexes. I got three of them. I got a whole crap load of Quetzals and a Spino. And come upstairs, and it looks so much cleaner. Don't it? It looks so much cleaner up here. I basically, if you remember from the last episode I did, I only had one ramp up there, and it was just ridiculous looking. So I decided just to finish it up like so. But the eggs are so much easier to pick up because they just roll down. Yeah, I got my two mammoths up here. I just got done mating another a Spino. So he came out to about 195. So, I mean, he's pretty much... it's a female, so I really need to get a male so I can, you know... get more dino eggs for this. But you know, he's like I said, he's just there, or she's just there for the fun of it for right now. But yeah, I mean, that's basically upstairs. I just redid it a little bit, make it look so much better. I also did some compost bins. I added a whole crap load more for Miss Picky over there. So yeah, but this is what we're gonna be going after right here. It's a Dung Beetle. Basically, what this is it holds animal feces for longer. That's like 2 minutes, or two days. And if you come over here to the compost bin, it's basically 11 days. So I mean, you only got 8 slots, but this here, like I said, you got a whole crop load more. But basically what the Dung Beetle does is it turns the feces matter into oil and compost, but only if it's wandering. But in order to do this, I will need to be doing I would need to make a greenhouse. So that might be in the next future. Building a greenhouse for that, for our Dung Beetles, so we can actually make them go and wander. But I also might move that too. I might move the, you know, my farm somewhere else, make it a little bit easier. Okay, let's just jump down, turn this off. Okay. But yeah, this is, like I said, I got a lot more stuff done on here. I'm trying to get it really completed. So, I mean, we got a whole crap load of eggs. All right, let's put away this gasoline because we don't need it. All right, let's get on Starburst here. Okay. I also made a taming bin right here. So, I mean, that's what that's there for. But if you can come over here. Like I said, I got my spinal. I got another spinal. I got three T-Rexes. They're a little leveled at the moment. This is like 190. I tamed that out at 143. You know, this one here was like a 94. These were twins, so that's why it's called twin one and twin two. These Quetzals were given, or not given, but they were just someone else's Quetzals. So they were inactive, as you can see, down Dunlimish, you know, in days. So in 3 days, I can demolish that. Same with this over here. This one here is a day. I can demolish all this and just basically go from there. This is only blooded because I decided to increase its health up more. Like I said, this one's a female. So I got two females, but I really need to get myself a male. Let me just go over here and show you exactly what's going on. And then we'll be right back. And we're back. This guy has been inactive for a while. As you can see, it's 5 days. But this guy's an ally for me. So what I've done is I decided to tame all his dinos. So all these dinos are mine, technically. There's a lot of dinos. Like I said, there's a couple of quets up here. And I decided to just basically help this guy out since I don't know if he's on vacation or whatever. But like I said, there's a whole bunch of Argies in there and other animals. But if you come over here, you'll see all his dinos are here. There's two spinals. So that's what I've been doing for my spinals. Is I've been mating these two spinals to get my two spinals that I have, because I don't have any spinals. And I've been trying to feed these dinos just to help the guy out, because like I said, I don't know if he's on vacation or whatever. But if he doesn't come back, you know, like I said, all these dinos are mine to do as I see fit. But I basically, like I said, I just puts a whole bunch of meat. You know, I've been feeding his dinos for him. Basically babysitting. But all right, let's go back over to the my fortress, and I'll show you exactly what I've been doing for that, and we'll be right back. Okay, and we're back. So we're over here to our fortress area, and I thought I saw something over there. But this is what I've been doing. I decided to tear the walls down completely and put some behemoth gates. As you can see, I did a behemoth gate right here. If you remember from the last episode I did, I had some walls up there. But now it's just a behemoth gate with gates and stuff. But I decided to do the behemoth gates all along the edge of the fortress. So that's basically... Ooh, look, snakey. Die, snake. We don't want any trespassers in our base. There's a lot of dinos in here, but that's why I said I gotta get these dino or behemoth gates in this, because like I said, all these dinos are spawning in here. But like you can see, I decided to do some behemoth gates with gateways up there, all along the edges of it. And to be honest with you, I kind of like it. But yeah, I'm gonna be putting some ramps right here. This is going to be the cutoff point right here. So this is going to get a behemoth gate, and this is going to get a behemoth gate, and I'm going to have some ramps all the way from, you know, from right here basically all the way around until over here. And then right here, as you can see, I'm going to put a doorway right here. So, I honestly, like I said, I actually like how this turned out. The backside, I'm not going to worry about it. I'm just going to make it all metal or glass, the back end. I'm not going to mess with too much behemoth gates because it does hurt on resource. This little portion right here, if you're wondering what this is going to be, like I said, it's going to be a doorway right here. So what this is going to be is this is going to be cut off. And basically all my generators and other stuff is going to be in this little area. And I started doing some ceilings just to get the feel of it. And to be honest with you, I like how it turned out. I really do. I honestly like how it turned out. It made it so much easier to get everything in place. And like I said, it's just I got a lot more work to do. And like I said, once the ceilings are in place, I might do another behemoth gate, you know, on top of the other behemoth gate, you know, to make it up high. And I think what I might do is this portion right here is going to be the cutoff point of the fortress. So yeah, I don't think I will go up as high as possible. I don't know, I might. But I brought my Spino down here, or my Stego, to get berries. Because I built a trough for it, for these dinos, because this is my wood and my stone dinos. But yeah, that's something that's going to happen. I mean, it's coming along. I've been putting a lot of work and effort into it. Still a lot more to go. But yeah, let's get on with the real video here, and let's go find that freaking beetle. You know, we'll be right back. Okay, and we're back. So what we have to go, the good place to get beetles, is you're going to come over here to 5563, which should be up here, if I'm not mistaken. 55, yep. All right, so this is where you want to go. You want to go to... basically 55.663. So what we're gonna do is you're gonna come jump down here. If you come over here, I'll show you on the map. This is basically where you're gonna go. Let's just put away the GPS here. Press E here. So that's where you're going to go, exactly right there, where it says me. But if you, when you come over here, you'll see this puddle. And when you see this puddle, you're basically just going to turn around, and you'll see this this cliff mountain area. And what you're going to do is you're going to jump down in it, just like so. And just be careful. And there's going to be some caterpillars, things in here. Make sure that you are careful with those, because if you're too close to it, they will break your armor. All right, so where the heck are all these dung beetles out here? So snakes, scorpions, kill this one. Don't need that dung beetle. Kill this dung beetle. This one I think we're going to keep. I think that's 110. Snake, spider. Scorpions. Oh shitload. Oh shit, snake. Two snakes. Two snakes for the price of one. Just come on down. And while you're down here, you'll see this nice little area. Man, it's just an underground like beautiful place. All these dinos, I mean, look at all these freaking dildodos. There's just so many freaking dodos, it's unbelievable. You can build a base here, a lot of people have already. But yeah, there's so many dinosaurs in this area, it's unbelievable. Most of them are passive. Passive meaning that they won't hurt you unless you attack them. But yeah. It's an easy way to level up, for sure. Come down here. I mean, that's what I would do. First off, just come down here and, you know, just kill some freaking dodos. Level up really quick when you're first starting out. All right, so we are after a level... we're after a dumb beetle here. Okay, what level is this dumb beetle here? 110. So, like I said, I think we're going to have to grab it. So let's pick them up with our quets. We got them. All right, let's go. Let's go back to our base, and yeah, that will be our bees. Okay, peeps, we are back. We're back at our base in the snowy mountain. We still got our dump beetle. Like I said, it's a passive tame. We're just gonna come up from behind them and go from there. But we can't let them see us. Stay there. Don't aggro me. All right, come up from behind him. Shit. He saw me. No! Run away! Run away, Ricky Bobby. Is he following me? What the hell? Really? What the hell's up with that? All right, so we're gonna grab some darts, and then we're gonna come over here to the my crafting table. We got a Mastercraft long rifle, and then once he wakes up, he should be out of threat. He should drop threat. Doing this will not mean that you're gonna tame him. It just means that it's not gonna work. Like once he's unconscious, it won't say that you can't do the inventory. So he's unconscious right now. So like I said, we're just gonna wait. We're just gonna wait until he drops threat and wakes up, and then we'll be right back. And we're back. That thing took forever to wake up. That's a bad method. I basically had to turn off the recording because it was just recording non-dead air. So that dumb beetle just finally woke up. Hopefully now we can come over here without it aggroing and pulling threat, and hopefully we can get up behind it without it seeing us. Hopefully we can tame this dumb beetle here. I'm gonna try to wait until it gets over there to the other wall. Okay, let's do this. Bingo. Just like that. That's how you tame it. It turned out to 164 for 110. It's really not the greatest. I really wished I could have found a 100 level 50, 150 dumb beetle, but 110 will do. I really wish I wouldn't have killed that 145. That would have helped us out just a hair. But let's just bring this bad boy upstairs. Oh, there's some Rex eggs. We gotta hurry up. So that dump beetle that I just grabbed was 150. This one right here. So it tamed out to 227, so that's pretty good. So basically, like I said, what this does is you put your you put the feces in there, and 36 minutes turns into 2 days. 2 days turns into 8 days. So yeah, that's what's gonna happen for that. But let's close this door. We don't need it. Ooh, we got some eggs over here. Holy moly. egg deluxe over here. Anybody want some scrambled eggs? Holy crap, look at all these eggs. Jeez. So yeah, this this method for when where I was doing this egg thing was not working out, but this is actually really stupid. All right. stupid Ankylo here. I hate that shit. They're rubber banding me with their tail. Arcdev needs to do something about that. That's just terrible. Rubber banding someone and shit. Alright, but like I said, let's just pick up all these eggs. We gotta hurry up and grab those. We gotta go grab the Rex eggs that was just laid. So let's go grab that really quick. We'll just jump down and grab those eggs before they despawn. Like so. Any Quetz eggs? Doesn't look like any Quetz eggs. But yeah, this Quetz right here is going to be my new... nope, not that Quetz. It's not the Quetz I was looking for. Where'd it go? Oh, this Quetz right here. Quetzy poo. This Quetz is going to be my... yep. This is going to be the Quetz I use when I go grab metal. So that Quetz is going to be my pride and joy. Alright, so let's just put these eggs down, and we'll go from here. Okay, let's just place all these eggs in. Got a whole crap load of eggs. So, yeah, that's how you tame a dumb beetle. It's one of those passive tames. What I'm planning on doing to my base... I want you guys' inputs. Help me out here. But what I'm planning on doing is my fortress base that I showed you with the pillars. I basically want to do the same exact thing over here. Extend it out. Extend this base out more. But if you guys want me to do that, like I said, make sure that you guys are telling me that you want me to do that. And I'll definitely do it. Like I said, whatever you guys decide for me to do, I'll definitely do. Because as you can see, how it's, you know, there's a dip right here. Putting a foundation down doesn't work. So I can't extend further this way without putting foundations or pillars. Because as you can see, there's a big cliff right here, big hill. So this doesn't work like you would assume. So that's why I decided to do some pillars, and then do some ceilings to extend it up higher off the ground, so I can actually extend it out farther this direction. But yeah, like I said, if you guys want me to do that, let me know. If I'm going to do this, all my supplies in there are going to get demolished. Because, like I said, I have to put pillars down. But like I said, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe. And if you guys haven't done so already, make sure to click this animation button right there. That will send you to a website that I made to pick the game that you want to see me play. It can be any game that's out on PC. I will definitely play it for you guys. I will go out and buy it for you guys. So you guys' inputs will help me out as a gamer channel. Help me grow. But until then, I'll see you guys on the next episode.